Hey, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we will be talking about polygons and how to classify them. In our previous lessons, we have learned about triangles and quadrilaterals. These shapes are polygons. But what makes them a polygon? Polygons are closed figures with three or more line segments. These shapes are all examples of polygons. Notice that all of these are closed figures. That means that all of the sides are attached at a vertex. And they all have three or more line segments, or sides. These figures are not polygons. The red and blue shapes have curved lines. Polygons do not have curved lines. The yellow figure has lines that intersect or cross each other. Polygons do not have lines that overlap. And the outline of the green figure is not closed. Notice that the lines are not connected at a vertex. Here are some common polygons with three sides all the way up to 10 sides. Here is a triangle, where tri means three. And a quadrilateral, where quad means four. A pentagon, where pent means five. And a hexagon, where hex means six. A heptagon, where hept means seven. And an octagon, where oct means eight. A nonagon, where non means nine. And a decagon, where dec means 10. There are two types of polygons. Regular and irregular. Regular polygons are equilateral and equiangular. Equilateral means that all of the sides are congruent. They are the same shape and size. And equiangular means all the angles are congruent. They are all the same measure of degrees. The equilateral triangle is a regular polygon. All three sides are the same length, and all three angles are 60 degrees. This octagon is also a regular polygon. All eight sides are the same length, and the eight angles are all 135 degrees. Irregular polygons have sides that are not congruent. That means they have side lengths that are not all the same length. They are also not equiangular. While some angles and sides might be the same size and shape, not all will be congruent. This parallelogram is an irregular polygon. It doesn't have four congruent sides and angles. And this hexagon is an irregular polygon. As you can see, the six sides are definitely not all the same length. We can draw diagonals in polygons to help us find the sum of interior angles. Remember, a diagonal is a line that is drawn from one vertex to another vertex that is non-consecutive, or not a neighboring vertex. So in this rectangle, if I start my diagonal at this vertex, the only other vertex I can draw my diagonal to is this one here. Now let's practice drawing diagonals in a polygon with more sides. Here I have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6-sided polygon. So a hexagon, and I'm going to pick one vertex to draw my diagonals from. We'll use this top one here. Now I can draw a diagonal to this vertex here, because it's not a neighbor, and to this one here, and to this one here. But I can't draw to these two vertices because they're neighbors. Do you notice anything special about the shapes these diagonals make in our hexagon? Yeah, that's right, they're triangles. How many triangles can you count? 1, 2, 3, 4. Do you remember what the sum of the interior angles for a triangle is? That's right, a triangle has 180 degrees. So if each of these triangles has 180 degrees, then the sum of the interior angles for all four triangles would be 180 plus 180 plus 180 plus 180, or 180 times 4. Which gives us 720 degrees. And since four triangles fit inside my hexagon, I can say the sum of the interior angles of a hexagon is also 720 degrees. Let's try another one. Here I have a heptagon. How many sides? 7. Now let's draw some diagonals from my top vertex. Now do you see some triangles again? How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now with my heptagon, what would be a very good way to find the sum of the interior angles? Well, if I have 5 triangles and I know each triangle is 180 degrees, I can just add those up, or say 180 times 5, which is 900 degrees. If it feels time consuming to draw all those diagonals, let's learn another method. Here is a table that shows polygons with different number of sides. How many triangles can you fit inside? Do you notice any patterns between the number of sides and the number of triangles that will fit inside a polygon? Yeah, it's always 2 fewer triangles than sides. Based on our pattern, how many triangles would fit in a decagon? That's right, 8 triangles would fit inside a 10-sided shape. We can write a formula to help us. We will say the number of sides minus 2 equals the number of triangles. And we can call the number of sides x. Now here I have an irregular, how many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it's an octagon with 8 sides. So without drawing diagonals, how many triangles can I fit inside? Remember, number of sides x minus 2 equals number of triangles. And if x I know is 8 minus 2, that'll be 6 triangles will fit inside. And if I know that I have 6 triangles, then I can say 6 times 180 degrees will be the sum of my interior angles. Let's see, so 180 times 6, I'm gonna go 6 times 8, 48, 6, that gives me 10. I bring my extra 0 down. So the sum of my interior angles is 1,080 degrees for this octagon. So if these are my two formulas, x minus 2 or number of sides minus 2 equals number of triangles, and number of triangles times 180 degrees equals the sum of the interior angles, I can plug in x minus 2 into the number of triangles in my second equation. And that will give me x minus 2 times 180 degrees equals the sum of interior angles. So all I need to know is the number of sides on my polygon, and I can calculate the sum of the interior angles. Great work studying polygons. Practice what you've learned by playing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever.